Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh to all my jelly beans. I hope you guys are keeping it halal, inshallah. So today's video, new scenery, I'm outside. We're running errands, so I'm like waiting for our hubby to come back from the store. So I figured I'll just do a quick video on something that I've been thinking about, subhanAllah. And last night I was just, you know, whatever, on my phone. I was just Googling different things. And the old post came up on Facebook from Umar. So subhanAllah, the Facebook post is about him talking about a sheikh that he met. I think the sheikh's name was Sheikh Ibrahim Bramali or Gramali. I'm not sure the last name. But according to Umar Suleiman, you know, he said that the sheikh was someone who really embodied the word sheikh, like in the true sense of the word, like he was, you know, subhanAllah. And this sheikh, he got sick and he was in the hospital for a very long time, for years. And so, Sheikh Umar Suleiman had the honor of like spending time with him in the hospital and different things. He said also while the sheikh was in the hospital, he actually fell into a coma, like a 12-day coma, and he didn't get up for 12 days. So the sheikh told him, like, during that 12-day coma, at one point he had a dream. And subhanAllah, the dream was about, you know, the hadith that talks about the three men who they were stuck in a cave and there was a boulder in front of the entrance. And each man took a turn making dua to Allah but stating a good deed that they did. Sorry guys, I'm trying to see which way the lighting is better. Basically, each man took a turn making dua to Allah and stating a good deed that they did sincerely, purely for the sake of Allah. And each time the men, you know, one by one said their dua, the boulder was moved. So subhanAllah, the sheikh said that in his dream he was one of those men. And each of the men took a turn, they said a dua, and the boulder moved. But after the third man did his dua, they were still, you know, they were still stuck inside. So it was his turn to, like, basically make dua to Allah, stating, like, a good deed that he did for the sake of Allah. And subhanAllah, he's a sheikh, right? So he said in the dream he was pacing back and forth, wondering, what deed have I done that literally is sincerely, purely, 100%? For the sake of Allah. And the sheikh finally, you know, after pacing back and forth, finally thought of a dua, and the boulder was moved, and that's when he woke up, subhanAllah, from the coma. And I just can't even, like, subhanAllah, that's insane, you know. And so Sheikh Umar Suleiman, like he said, like he was reflecting on that, like, what deed can I literally honestly tell Allah, like, I did for the sake of you, like 100% with pure intentions, not like not even a stinge of like insincerity within it. And subhanAllah, I just started thinking, like, wow, I've been Muslim for 9 years, you know, and subhanAllah, I feel like my relationship with Allah is not where I want it to be yet. I'm not really happy with where I'm at. Like, I feel like I could be closer to Allah than I am right now, subhanAllah. And I don't know, like, I just started thinking, like, wow, a lot of us think that we're good people and we say, oh, I'm a good person, I don't bother anyone, I don't do anything wrong or whatever. But really though, like, really, like, are we really good people in the true sense of the word, a good person? I feel like there's so much more that I could be doing. For one, I'm speaking on myself, I don't really know anyone else. Sorry guys, I feel like it's so dark here, so I'm trying to get light. So basically, like, I'm just sitting here like, wow, I've been Muslim for 9 years, is there a deed that I could say I truly did it for the sake of Allah? And I'm pretty sure those deeds are probably in the beginning of when I converted, you know, because I had that zeal for Islam, I had that, like, thirst for Islam, and I wanted to do everything, and, like, I wanted to do so many things, and I used to do so many things. And now I'm thinking, like, you know, how can I get back to that or whatever? And that's one of the reasons, like, I don't put out YouTube videos, like, every week and certain stuff, because, like, when I put out a video, I want to make sure that I'm really sincere about what I'm talking about, and I want to talk about it from a place that it's, like, it's passionate. I'm talking about it because I feel passionate about this topic. Like, I don't want to just make YouTube videos on topics and just speak about things that either I don't do, or, you get me? Like, I just don't want to make videos just to make videos just to get subscribers. Like, I want to make a video because I truly feel passionate about that. And that's the thing with YouTube, like, when you're on YouTube, these things, like, Allah is gonna ask you, like, were you on YouTube for the sake of me, for the sake of putting out the word, or are you just on YouTube for the sake of subscribers and stuff? So basically, listening to Omar Suleiman while reading that status, like, really got me thinking. And it also made me think, like, subhanAllah, so many of us think, like, you know, I'm going to Jannah, like, that's it. Like, we really do think Jannah's written for us. And it's like, no, we really need to stop and assess where we're at. Like, if I died right now, subhanAllah, do I really think, like, I'd be going to Jannah? The thing is, like, so many people, when we talk about Allah, we always talk about, oh, the good, like, all the attributes of Allah are good. But I'm saying we always talk about Allah, like, Allah is most merciful, Allah is most forgiving, you know, Allah's gonna forgive me, Allah's gonna do this, but Allah also says, like, he's severe in punishment, like, that should scare us, you know. And we know that we'll get to Jannah with the mercy of Allah, but really, let's stop being biased, I guess, when we talk about Allah, or let's stop being one-sided when we talk about Allah. Like, no, Allah can punish you, and there's some things that he might not forgive. Like, you don't know that. So you can't just ride on that, like, oh, well, Allah knows my intentions, Allah's gonna forgive me, whatever it is. When we say Allah knows my intentions, are we really realizing that, like, he knows our full intention? He knows that if there's a hint of insincerity within our intention, like, we just say it, like, you know, it's given. I don't know. These are just what I was thinking about, and I just really wanna, like, Umar bin Al-Khattab said, like, hold yourself accountable before you're held accountable. And, like, really, I'm, like, thinking, like, what percentage of my day do I just, I'm just in dunya stuff, you know, versus being in, thinking about the deen or whatever. And obviously, doing dunya stuff could be worship too, again, based on your intention or whatever it is. But yeah, I just wanted to put a quick reminder out there. That's all, just what I've been thinking about and stuff. So inshallah, if you have any other opinions on that, or you want to chime in on this discussion, definitely first subscribe, hit the notification bell, and then leave a comment. Inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.